Welcome to Soul Rhema Ministries Homegrown Series, brought to you by the Household of Faith. Today I want to talk to you about failure in the garden. It's a part of gardening. Not everything you plant, not every seed is going to germinate, and then not every plant is going to grow and produce. This is what I call my number two green container. Now, originally, I put in butternut squash, spaghetti squash, acorn squash. There's a black radish down in there somewhere. And mint, which seems to be very prolific and very lemony. It's actually doing the only thing, and the radish was down in here. Can I even still see? Oh, here the radish is down in there. It's a black radish. I was excited and I wanted to see about it. But what we're talking about is plants that just don't want to grow. I have some more. This is the purple tomatillo plant. It's very temperamental. I've got it in the shady spot. I water it twice a day. And as you can see, it's dying. That this is a lettuce plant. It's just leaning up against it. That's not part of it. But see, right here at this juncture, this whole section here is dying. Don't know why, and it only happened within the last couple of days. Probably a bug got to it, or I don't know, maybe it just got bent in the wrong direction too many times. I can't really tell. There's no real reason for it, but it's dying. All of that dead you can see right there. And then here is the grandbaby of all the dead stuff. This is the cucumber trellis. It has not really produced any cucumbers. I got one very small lemon cucumber that was about the size of a quarter. I mean, really, come on. I don't know why it died. It'll grow for a while and then it'll just die. So it's dying from the bottom. There's a lot of good water in here. Marigolds, the chives, all of that other stuff is doing great. Except for the cucumber plant itself. The part that's green looks good. There's no discernible disease, no pest issues, but yet they're dying. Now, had to move back because there was a little bee visiting. I just don't understand what's going on with it. But what I want to make sure that you understand is that plants die. Not all of them are going to live, no matter how well you take care of them, no matter how much you think you know. And let me just say this, no one is an expert. I am not coming to you as an expert saying, I know all. No, ma'am. I am on the internet. I'm at the library looking in books. I go to Farmer's Almanac, you know, and I do look at some YouTube to see, you know, get some tips on how to get things to grow. But for some reason, I've got several sections that are just not doing anything at all. And it's the plants themselves. I don't feel like I've done anything wrong. I really believe that it's the plants. Prepare yourself when you garden, plants die. For me, I'm sad because none of the cucumbers are making it. None of them. Not one. It's too late in the season. This is mid-August. I am not about to plant any more cucumbers. Why? Because I'm planning on moving in October. Late October, November to Colorado. I don't have time. And I don't have time to worry over and baby and kiss and a plant that just doesn't want to live. At some point, just let it die. One of the things that if they weren't all right here, I could have planted another cucumber plant somewhere else to see if maybe, you know, there was something I was missing that was going on behind the scenes. I didn't do that this year. This trellis used to be out in the sun. It produced cucumbers last year. This year, not so much. this is going to happen. I've been having problems all season long with my squash plants. And speaking of squash, this is the last zucchini plant, what's left of it, that I'm going to grow this year. The squash bugs got to the first set of them. I wrapped them up in foil, and after doing some research to see how I could save them, and I did get some yellow squash and some Mexican gray, but the zucchini, no. This one I started in the hydroponic, got it big and brought it out here. It survived. And now, I came out the next day, and it was dead. And I just left it there. What I want you to understand is that when you garden, plants will die. House plants die. Food plants die. All kinds of plants, they all die. Sometimes it's not your fault. Sometimes you can neglect a plant, and it'll just grow like crazy. So you never know what they're going to do. And wrapping this up, this is what I call container number one. It has Korean melon, basil, and a couple other squash plants. It's not specific that this plant is dying, but vining plants do, the leaves do get a little ugly. And I don't see any new melons on here. I just harvested three. And so far, I've gotten five off of this plant, and which is great. I've never grown it before. I got it from the plant swamp. I'm really happy with how it produced. I want to save some of the seeds and try again. Remember, plants die. I can't stress that enough. Do not stress out over if your plant dies. If it looks like this, okay, examine it. Find out what's wrong. You know, there is some evidence of some little bug issues here. I've seen white flies on a lot of the plants. I can treat this with neem oil, but I have to do it at night. I can spray it down with the dish soap solution, but it has to be done at night before the sun hits it. Now, I still have a couple more hours before the sun hits this plant, you know. But what I'm telling you is that when you've done everything you can do to save a plant, it lives or dies. This is mid-August in the north central Texas. It's over 100 degrees for the next month. If they're struggling right now, they're going to keep struggling, and they're probably going to die. I will keep watering them as long as I see they're growing, but at some point, you just have to let it go. Every melon, cucumber, tomatillo, the ones that I've shown you, they all produce hundreds of seeds. It's easy to start another plant. I would not start another plant this time of year because I got plans for the fall, and they don't include being out here slaving in the garden. I'm going to be moving to Colorado, whole different environment. But what I want to tell you is that we pray over our plants. We ask God to bless them. We ask Him to teach us and show us how to grow properly. We do our own research. You know, we go to YouTube, we go to the, you know, we join a plant group, whatever. I mean, there's so many different options that we have now today that we can get some assistance with helping and making our plant life better. So when all is said and done, if you've done everything you can do for your plant, you prayed over your plant, then that's it. Because God gives the increase no matter what. And remember that. If it dies, okay. So remember, your plants have a lot of, I hate to call it enemies, because some of them are helpful, but some of them are harmful. If it's a fruit-bearing plant and it needs flowers pollinated, you need the pollinators. You need the moths. You need the bees. You need the ants. You need all of those and the butterflies. You need them to pollinate, or you're going to have to get out there and hand pollinate. And that can be a lot. All right? So just remember, gardening should not be stressful. Gardening should be relaxful. And it's also hard work. So, you know, between the two of them, you're going to get something that you need. I want to say God bless you. Continue to trust God in everything that you do. God bless.